G'day guys, welcome to my Bonzo channel. Today we're going to have a quick look at CleanMyMac X. I bought this years ago when my Mac was starting to run a little slowly. And I'm just going to show you how it works. While I tell you a bit about why I bought this, I'm just going to run a quick scan. So we're just going to hit scan and I'm going to let it do its things. So it's going to clean up, look for unwanted files, it's going to check to make sure my computer's protected, and then it's going to see if there's any speed improvements it can do. So, the way I look at it, CleanMyMac is like a little mechanic living in my computer looking for things, you know. So like you take your car to a mechanic, you know, your mechanic checks your car, does a service on it, makes sure your car's always running well. If you don't take it to the mechanic often enough to get it serviced, then the car starts to develop problems, and those problems could cause a major headache later on. And I think it's the same thing with a computer. If you don't service your computer properly, it will tend to slow down, it becomes sluggish, and things that could cause that would be like, you know, files. You've got all these unwanted files on there, it's hogging up your hard space. It won't allow the computer to swap memory, you know, to increase the speed, so it tends to slow right down and it can get really bad. That's why I bought CleanMyMac, and I haven't looked back since. So I actually did a scan yesterday just to because it needed it, and it deleted about 12 gigs or so. So that's why it's only found 623.7 megabytes. So it took a bit longer yesterday because it was more to go through. Today it was quite quick, as you can see. So it's found 623.7 megabytes. My malware protection was fine, and there's three tasks to run to increase the speed. So what you do then is you just run. We'll get rid of that. That's your notification. And it's gonna close the browsers because it needs the clean files with that the browsers tend to hold onto, and it needs to close that to do that. So you just hit quick all, and it will do that. Now, once you installed it, you've got your little Mac icon up there, you clean my Mac, and it tells you a quick rundown of what's happening on your Mac. So how much available space you've got, how much memory you're using, what your battery levels are at the moment. Mine's 100% because it's plugged in, and as you can see, it's already done. And now it's opening up all my browsers that it closed previously. Okay, so it says run a deep scan. So I won't do that today, because if I run a deep scan, it's gonna take a lot longer and we're not gonna have time for that. So I'll just quickly go through what you can do with this thing. So as I was saying before, I was interrupted by CleanMyMac. That just gives you a quick rundown of what's happening on your computer. System junk. I'm not sure what that does. We'll give it a quick scan, see what happens. I don't use everything that's on this. I just let it do an automatic scan, and that's all I'm fussed about. So, okay, it's found 10.7 megabytes. We can clean that. Again, it's got to close the browsers. That's fine. So that's something I haven't done. It will check your mail attachments, your trash bins, malware. There's a shredder. I haven't used a shredder before. Now, the shredder is if you've got, like, if you're one of those little secret agents type people who have all these secret files on their computer, if you delete these files normally, someone who knows what they're doing can always get those files back. But if you use a shredder, it shreds those files, and then it's impossible for anybody to see what you had on your computer. Like I said, I haven't got anything like that. But I suppose if I was going to sell my Mac, I would use that to get rid of files before I sold it. Large and old files, you click that, it will just scan quickly and find all your large files. And then you can go through it, say, okay, yeah, screen recording. That's taken up 1.64 gigabytes. Do I need that? If you say no, you can highlight it. Click all the ones you don't need, hit remove, and it just deletes those files. So that's quick and easy. Space lens, that one I haven't used, but apparently once you scan that, it just goes through the whole hard drive and it puts everything in its files. So you can check individual files, see which one holds the most information. You can go through it, work out which ones you do need, which ones you don't need, delete all the ones you don't need, and that again saves you a lot more room on your hard drive and also makes it a lot easier. So as you can see, it did that quite quickly as well. I've got 147 gigabytes on my in my users, which is my system account. If I was to click on that, it would break it down further. Click that on that again, it'll break it down even further, so you can see where all those files are. Then you can suss out those files and you can delete the ones that you think aren't necessary. So that's that. Maintenance, that's what we just did before. Optimization, we did that one as well. That all was in your general scan. So that's generally it. That's what CleanMyMac does. It just services your computer, make sure it's in tip-top shape so you get the best speed out of it. And I haven't had a problem with it. I've had it, like I said, I've had it for years. So if your Mac's running slowly, you may want to give it a go. There's something else that I've discovered quickly. I just want to show you. It's not picking that up at the moment, but it's usually, maybe because I'm using my phone to record, but it usually picks up your phone as well. So you can actually clean your phone using CleanMyMac and another free app that you can get, which is made by MacPaw, and that goes through your phone and cleans up your phone. If I can get that to work later on, I may have to use a different program to do it, and I can show you how that works. I'll put that in a future video, which you won't see unless you subscribe. So yeah, if you haven't done so already, you can click down below to subscribe. And once you've done that, hit the bell and select all so you don't miss out on future videos. And especially my Laughaholics, which are really funny jokes that I put online. And I do one of those every week. As always, guys, loved having you here. Hope to see you next time. This is Peter from My Bonzo Channel signing off. Catch you later, guys.